Please.
Morata, Luiz, and William are out. And the other players are available.
Is Michy Batshuayi trained today?
Yeah, he's in contention for tomorrow's game.
Because obviously he's been linked with a move to the Bundesliga, and their deadline is tomorrow afternoon, so it would be tight for him to join a German club now if he's still here this afternoon.
I don't know, but now he's a Chelsea player, and for this reason, he's in contention for tomorrow's game. Also because I have Morata that is injured, and I don't have other options, and especially if Willian is also injured, and others can play number 9. And then to find a solution, or to find another number 10.
Forgive me, because it is very close now to the deadline. I know you don't like questions, but bear with me just one more time before we can finish it all. Are you looking to bring in another forward, hopefully before tomorrow evening?
I can hope everything, but the most important things are to. It's the reality, and now the reality is that is this, and I have to prepare the game in the right way with these players, and I'm very happy to do this. And as you know very well, I always say that I will be happy in both cases if the club decides to add players, but otherwise I'm very happy to continue to work with these players, because they show me every day great behaviors, great commitment, and but the only my hope to finish very soon this transfer market, especially because in this way you can change the question for me. Yeah, no, you were in general. Yeah.
Edin Dzeko just didn't work out in the end. It didn't. The maths weren't right.
No, but as you know well, I don't like to speak about the players of the other teams. But I think that is a Roma's players, and. I think that he will be he will continue to be a Roma's player.
Talking about Roma players, Emerson Palmieri is almost here. We understand that Chelsea may be having a medical even.
Yeah, and if you remember, I said that in case the club decides to send on loan Kennedy, and we have two options, or to buy another player, or to work with a young player like Sterling, that is a young player but a very good prospect for Chelsea, and but I don't know, and if there are news, the club will inform you about new players.
Palmieri will be a player you will remember, though, from the Italian league.
No, I must be honest. I don't remember Palmieri, because he played in Italy only last season. Last season he had an important season for Rome. And then he had a bad injury. He broke his ligament. Now he's recovering. I don't know if he's ready to play. Yeah, I know that he played only one game in Italy Cup against Turin. Yeah, but I repeat, we are talking about a player of another team in this moment.
Just two more names. Olivier Giroud continues to be linked with Chelsea. Is that a player you were ever interested in?
As I said before, I give my opinion to my club, and then the club is trying to do the best in the transfer market, and I can speak about specific characteristic of the players. The role that we can improve, but we are talking about the players of another team. I think that it's right to continue to have respect for the player, for the team.
And Fernando Llorente, we know you like him because you tried to buy him in the summer. If he was available again, would you show interest again?
I don't know, but in the summer. The summer was the summer. Now we are in January, it's winter. Yeah, and it's a different situation. And I repeat, we are talking about players of the other of the other team.
Last question, just to really annoy you. David Luiz has been added to the injury list.
Yeah.
Injured. Nothing
other
than injured.
Yeah, and he's injured. Before the game, before the 2 days before the game against Newcastle. An injury in his ankle, and then he's trying to recover, and he needs a bit of time to recover.
Is it difficult to prepare for a game tomorrow when you probably don't know if a player, Michy Batshuayi, who could be quite important to you tomorrow, might not actually be around or play or here?
Yeah. I think for sure this is not the best situation to prepare a game, a league game against Bournemouth. But. There are this type of situation you must be prepared to face, and to prepare the game also in these situations. But for sure, it hasn't been easy to prepare the game in this way.
How would you describe the last month off the pitch, the transfer window? How would you sum it up? Has it been frustrating for you?
No, not frustrating, no, but really annoyed for this period, and also because to play every three days, and it means that you must have a press conference every 3 days, and I must be honest, in this period it's very difficult.
What's annoyed you? Is the transfer window annoyed you? Is it to us that's annoyed you? What's annoyed you?
To have always the same questions, and then if our target is this, our target is another. If the relationship is good, it's not good, and if I'm happy, if you are unhappy, and
that's
naturally for you, but that you stay there. But for me, that I stay here every 3 days, and to have always the same question is a bit frustrated. Yeah, this is a bit frustrated.
Okay,
yes.
One more.
Yeah, I'm joking. Yeah.
Has it been a distraction though, on the field, or what's been going on around you in the club and the transfer window? Has it distracted the players, yourself?
I hope not. Also because we send along two players, like. Musonda and Kennedy, and I don't see my players with great distraction about this period. And then for sure there is the situation, and Batshuayi situation, and Yeah, but at the same time, I ask to my players to be focused on the game, to be focused on our target. Our target is to try to play a good game, to try to get 3 points. For us, it will be very important to win the game tomorrow against Bournemouth. It won't be easy, especially because there are these little situations to solve, and I hope when we finish this transfer market to be more relaxed and to try to be focused on our work.
So if we see Batshuayi involved or playing tomorrow night, I presume we can assume that he's staying, is he? If he's involved tomorrow night.
Yeah, but against Newcastle, you can see that against Newcastle, I decided to start with him, and this show that for me the most important things is the present, not is the future, because we have to face every 3 days one game. In this case. Against Newcastle, tomorrow against Bournemouth, and for us it's very important to look at the present, because if you think and you look at the future, you risk to do a lot of mistakes.
Thank you.
Antonio, hi. Two questions about the match, not about the transfer window. The first one, can you confirm Courtois and Fabregas are okay for selection?
Yeah. Courtois and Fabregas are okay for selection.
And you played Bournemouth twice, close games. They've changed to a back three when they played against you. What are your thoughts about playing them, the nature of the game, the challenge for Chelsea tomorrow?
Yeah, and tomorrow is a big challenge for us because this period is finishing, and for us it will be very important this period, for me the transfer market period, not January, but only because in January there is the transfer market, and for many reasons, and you can have a distraction, but I'm very happy. I'm very happy because I have players with great focus, and also today the training was positive, was great. The commitment, the behaviors of all my players, and tomorrow we have to face not only Bournemouth, but difficult situations, because I repeat, the transfer market is closing. There are one problem that we have to face, and then we have to face injuries problems, because to miss Morata, Willian, and to have this situation in balance, no, with Batshuayi, is not simple to prepare the game and to face this game. But no excuse, not alibi. We don't, the most important thing is don't find excuse. Tomorrow we want to try to get 3 points. We had to play against a team that rested from 10 days, and they had a lot of days to prepare this game. Instead, we are playing every 3 days. Yeah, a lot of of problems. And for this reason, I think that the game tomorrow, it won't be easy. For us.
Okay, a couple more. Simon, please.
I think you implied, Antonio, already. So, Michy Batshuayi is in the right frame of mind to play tomorrow. Have you spoken to him to check that he's in the right frame of mind to play?
But for sure, in this type of situation, the coach has to speak with the player, no? With the player that is involved in this type of situation. It's not simple. It's not a simple, this situation. It's a Batshuayi situation. No? And there is only one day. This is not the best situation for me, for the player. But as you know very well, a transfer market in January is not simple. To find a solution, to come in, to find a solution to go out to players. But the players knows very well, no, the situation. And today he trained well, and I prepared the game with him. And but you don't know what happened tonight or tomorrow. But we must be ready to face every situation. It won't be easy. For me, this is not the best situation to face, but we had to face.
And just one last one for me. Do you think, you had this last year as well, do you think the deadline day, there should be no fixtures played on transfer deadline day because of this situation?
Should they have matches played on deadline day? Because it makes it too difficult.
Yeah, I think there's this... this is not right. This is not right. And to have a match, and when there is the deadline of transfer market, I think that this is not right. This is not right, and you can have this type of situation to have players that stay half and half. Yeah, I think in the future, who decide the future, reflect a bit before to prepare this type of a situation. No? Because, I repeat, now I have to face this situation. There are many coaches that doesn't like to have a game when there is the deadline of the transfer market.